The nuzzling image, typically with any of the artwork that I'm creating, you have to start with a good photograph. And it generally will have a strong subject. And we do a lot of outings with the local camera club. And when I'm out on an outing, I will look for those types of images that will make a good painting. Something that I would really want to do with traditional media. Once I capture the photo, I will bring it into Photoshop. I'll adjust color balance, brightness, saturation, you name it, and try to get the best photo that I can. Once I get that, then I would tend to look at the image and say, is that the composition that I actually want? If not, I will go in and I'll crop, rotate, do whatever it is necessary to make that image as good as possible. After that, I usually will resize the image to the finished product that I'm trying to print. The reason I do that, because I'm laying down the equivalent of an oil painting and it has the brush strokes in it, I don't want those brush strokes to be enlarged or reduced in size. I want them to look natural. So I will resize the image to the finished product. After that, I bring it back into Photoshop and I look for any distracting elements. In this particular photo, I had a fence post, and what I normally would do is clone that out and get the image to the point where it would make a good painting. If you're using traditional media, you just don't paint the fence post. But with photography, it sees everything. We need to take that out. Once I get the picture, and this is about the final form that the photo is in, I will load it into the painting software. And for this particular photo, I use Corel Painter. I load it in and bring up the cloning smeary oil brush, and I start painting on the photo. It leaves the bristle marks very similar to the traditional media. Whenever you're doing these clonings, what it is, the analogy would be a sheet of tracing paper or tracing canvas, if you will, on top of the photo, and we're just painting on top. What the cloning process does is it actually brings up the colors from the photo, and it will put in the brush strokes. If you have color already laid down, it will blend with the colors that are already there. So it is very much a process similar to the traditional oil paints. So I generally will start on the background, fill in the background, and once the background is laid down, I will get in and start working on the main subject, in this case, the foxes. And that way we will get sharp edges on the edges of the main subject against the background. Once we are satisfied and have the whole canvas covered with oil paint, what I typically will do is add another layer and I will add some accents. And this is going to help give the illusion, at least, of a sharper image. And after that, we save it as a JPEG and print it.